Learn more on BBC Bitesize.
I'm here in Wales carrying out coastal fieldwork, looking at longshore drift and sea defences. Longshore drift moves sand and shingle along the beach, which can expose the land behind the beach to greater levels of erosion. Fieldwork can be both quantitative and qualitative. First, we're going to use quantitative data, which is measurable and numbers-based. Our coastal fieldwork is going to see how effective groins are by measuring their exposed height. If you're doing fieldwork with your class, follow your teacher's instructions. Stay with your group and stay away from breaking waves or deep water. Today I'm going to be assessing groins, concrete, wooden or rock barriers. These prevent erosion inland by limiting longshore drift and building up a beach. To do this, I'm going to gather quantitative data to see how effective groins are by measuring their exposed height. To start this measurement, I work from where the sea breaks right up to the end of each groin, taking measurements at regular intervals of 1 metre. At each interval, I measure and record the height of each side of the exposed groin, like this. If a groin is disrupting longshore drift, sand will accumulate on the updrift side. This means that we'd expect to see a smaller updrift measurement as the groin has trapped sand, meaning that less of it is exposed. Another way that we can evaluate groins is using qualitative data. This is descriptive data. For example, we can use a bipolar analysis. This is a method where we make visual judgments and give them a score. I'm going to be scoring from -3, the lowest, up to +3, the highest, for questions such as how long lasting do they look? For example, these look really long lasting, so I'm going to give them a 3. The higher the score, the more effective we can say a groin is. These are just two of the techniques used for coastal fieldwork, but through a balance of quantitative and qualitative methods, we are now able to make a judgment about the coastal management on the beach.
For in-depth GCSE resources and practice, visit BBC Bitesize now.